Certificate under section 195 subsection 2 applied by the payer. So in a transaction there will be two people. One is the person who's making the payment or the payer. The other one is the payee. The application under section 195 subsection 2 is made by the payer. Now let us suppose the payer has to make a payment of $100 to, let's say, person called X. Now the person who's making the payment, let's say this is in the nature of business income. He does not know whether the tax should be withheld on 100, because being business income, there may be certain expenses which have to be allowed as a deduction, right? So in order to determine what portion of such amount is chargeable to tax, right? Whether it is $50, whether it is 40, whether it is 20, whether it is 10, he can make an application to the assessing officer requesting him to determine the appropriate amount which is chargeable to tax. Now, one thing you need to note here is that if he believes that the amount which is chargeable to tax is zero, which means this amount is exempt from tax, application under section 195 subsection 2 cannot be made to confirm this aspect, right? The payer may make an application to the assessing officer for grant of certificate determining the appropriate portion of such sum which will be chargeable to tax, so that he may apply withholding tax on such portion only. So if you look at it from a legal perspective, the application can be made only to determine how much of such sum is chargeable to tax. In other words, whatever is chargeable is what? It is nothing but the income. So the application is more to determine the income element comprised in this amount. Such application would be made only when payer considers that whole of such payment to non-resident would not be income chargeable to income tax. So if the non-resident believes that the entire amount is chargeable to tax as income, obviously he doesn't need to make an application to the assessing officer, because in such a case he can just apply the tax rate to this amount. It is only when he knows that there is some income element in this but is not sure what exactly that quantum is that he can make an application under section 195 subsection 2. AO cannot be approached to grant a certificate that no tax is payable on any gross sum payable by the payer. So from a legal perspective, and then there are case laws to this effect also, that if you think that the entire amount is not chargeable to tax, it's zero, you cannot just go to the AO to confirm that aspect through an application under section 195 subsection 2. Now let's move to the other side, right? Certificate of nil withholding tax under section 195 subsection 3 applied by the non-resident payee, that is the recipient. A non-resident payee, right, who may either be a non-corporate non-resident, which means anyone other than a foreign company, or a foreign company, may, they have a choice to make such an application, make an application to the assessing officer for grant of a certificate authorizing him to receive interest or other sum on which TDS has to be deducted under section 195(1) without deduction of tax thereunder. So in under 195(3), the application can be made for nil withholding tax. What are the payments which are covered? It could be interest or other sum which are chargeable to tax. Generally, the recipient for this purpose are classified into two categories. One could be a banking company and the other could be others, right? So for making an application to the assessing officer for such nil withholding tax thing, there are various conditions that each one of them needs to satisfy, right? We'll just look at those conditions in the next slide. But before that, one thing which we should know is that if any such certificate is granted, so the AO gives a certificate, every person responsible for paying such interest or other sum to the person to whom the certificate is granted shall make payment of such interest or other sum without deduction of tax at source under section 195(1) so long as the certificate is in force. So if the AO says that there is no tax which has to be withheld on this, the payer, the person who has to make the payment to the non-resident payee, has to deduct tax according to such certificate. Of course, each such certificate is valid for a given period and for certain given amounts. As long as the period for which it is valid subsists or exists and the payment is within the amounts mentioned in this certificate, then in those cases the payer has to follow this certificate. They cannot choose to ignore it. Coming back to who all can be the applicant can be a foreign banking company, right? It should not be an Indian company, or a foreign company which has made prescribed arrangement for declaration of dividend in India, right? Or if it is not falling in this category, it can be any other person carrying on business in India through a branch. So if there is a non-resident, he has a branch in India, right? And he's carrying on business in India through this branch, even he can approach for lower withholding tax certificate, or sorry, nil withholding tax certificate under section 195, subsection 3. Now, this foreign banking company, what can they apply for? I mean, what should be the nature of income for which 195(3) can be applied? Any income by way of specified interest or any other sum. They can apply for any specified interest. You need to refer to the section to see what all interest are covered, or any other sum. But it should not be any specified interest or dividend which is receivable by the branch on its own account. What this means is that if suppose the foreign banking company has a branch in India and this branch receives certain interest or other sum which are relating to the activity of the branch, right? The foreign company cannot apply for a nil withholding tax certificate in respect of such amounts. The reason is simple. Such an income of the branch is taxable in India, right? And therefore, for such income, this certificate cannot be given. But for any other interest or other sum which is payable to the foreign company, which is not related to the branch, for that, such a certificate can be applied for. Similarly, for any other non-resident who's carrying on business in India through a branch, any sum other than interest or dividend receivable by the branch on its own account. So if this non-resident gets any other sum, right, which is other than dividend or interest, which is relating to the activities of the branch, for that it can go and apply for a nil withholding tax certificate under section 195, subsection 3. Now, before such an application can be made, there are certain conditions which are required to be satisfied. If you satisfy these conditions, your application under section 195(3) is valid and maintainable. If you do not satisfy this condition, then such an application may not be tenable. What are these conditions? The applicant, and now this is applicable to both the foreign banking company or other person, right? Is regularly assessed to tax in India and has filed all returns due before the date of the application. So one, you should be regularly assessed to tax in India. Two, whatever returns were due that you have to file in respect of your income in India, they have already been filed before the date of application. Second, he is not in default. So there's a concept of being assessee in default. The applicant should not be an assessee in default, or should not be deemed to be an assessee in default for any tax, interest or penalty which is payable under the Income Tax Act. Now, these two conditions are applicable to both foreign banking company and other businesses. Now, additionally, for application made by non-banking company, which means this other applicant, the person should have carried on business in India for a period of 5 years immediately preceding the date of application. So your business should have been carried on in India for at least 5 years. The value of fixed assets in the books of accounts for last financial year should exceed 50 lakh. So if you are making an application on, let's say, 1st May 18, your 31/3/18 financials should have fixed assets of at least rupees 50 lakh. The application has to be made in Form 15C by the foreign banking company and in Form 15D by any other person. The third mode through which a certificate for deduction of tax at lower rate can be obtained is under Section 197, and this can be applied for by the non-resident recipient or the non-resident payee. The application for lower deduction or nil deduction of TDS can be made by the non-resident payee in Form 30. So under Section 197, you can apply for both lower deduction of tax or nil deduction of tax. So if I were to compare this with 195(3), there lower deduction was not possible. Here lower or nil deduction is possible. Such application can also be made before commencement of financial year. So if you want to apply for, let's say, financial year 18-19, you can make an application before 31/3/2018 also. Normally these applications take 1 to 2 months, right? And therefore, in order to ensure that by the time the financial year start, you already have this certificate, you can actually file it before the commencement of that financial year. Now, whether they will accept it or not, whether they will process it or not, because year-end pressures are always there on the tax office as well, that's a different thing. No certificate for lower deduction or nil deduction shall be issued if the non-resident payee does not provide PAN. So that means that the recipient has to have a PAN number. And where such certificate is granted by the AO, the payer is required to deduct tax as per the rate given in such certificate. Right? Now, obviously, these two things are given, that the lower withholding tax or the nil withholding tax shall be deducted up to the limit of income specified in such form. So if you initially estimated that you are going to get $1 million of payment and you made an application for this, but you got $1.5 million as taxable income, then this $0.5 million will be subject to tax at regular rates. The lower rate will be applicable only for the amount mentioned in the application. Where payment to non-resident exceeds the amount mentioned in the certificate, withholding tax shall be deducted as per normal rate on any excess payment. Right? So now let's look at what is the validity period of the certificate. So the validity period will be generally the period mentioned in the certificate. Normally a certificate would mention that the certificate is valid up to the end of a given financial year. So let's say it may mention that it is valid until 31/3/19, but it also mentions unless cancelled, which means that if the certificate is cancelled before 31/3/2019, let's say on 31 December 2018, the assessing officer realized that this certificate was obtained through fraud and it cancels the certificate, then it is valid for any deduction which has been done up to this date. Right? The certificate for non-deduction shall remain in force till the expiry of the period specified therein or cancellation of withholding certificate by the AO, 31st March 2019, or if it is cancelled, until that date. Such certificate for non-deduction of TDS is given on an yearly basis. You cannot obtain a certificate for 5 years collectively. Thus, there is no auto-renewal of such certificate and the payee needs to apply for it again in the next year. So you cannot obtain one certificate and continue with it for more than 1 year, even though the original contract that you had is for a period of more than 1 year. You need to go afresh, file the documents afresh and get a new certificate every year.